And hello again, Internet. Here we are with day 6, I believe, of Realms of the Haunting, after I missed a very important item yesterday. And I'm just going to say I'm a bit tired today. We had some excitement in the house last night of the unpleasant variety, you know, involving people where they're not supposed to be, police and the like, so I'm a little tired. Don't really want to get into it, just, ugh. So tired, in fact, that I just about started the game without starting the stream, so I'm a little out of it, which is going to be great for doing a puzzle game. So here we are. Open the door. And I know what was missing now. I looked it up. This welcome mat. As you can see, you actually can interact with it.
Well used.
So I have to come in, look down, use it. I get this nifty magic wand. That gets rid of the symbol. And I gotta be careful, because as you saw, one of those tried to explode anyway. So, joy. I'm pretty much right now just going to go through and get rid of all of the runes that I can. I'll worry about opening doors and looking for items after that. Because as you know, once you take off those green runes, you can only see with the flashlight down there active. And every time I pick something up, it goes in that hand instead of the flashlight. Interesting. I said I'll be exploring more later.
Jesus. What the hell?
Hello. Don't think I want to go in there just yet then. Ah! Stop it, door. Now I gotta put that wand on a thing so I can use it. Well, let's put it there. Don't need the cult anymore, in theory. Where'd you go, dude? You're here somewhere. Or not. Whatever. Come back to it later. Three should be the wand. No, that's not the... What the heck? There we go. That's what's supposed to be there. Did I already go this way? Yeah. Okay. Apologize for being so tired. Whoa! That actually scared me. Alright, let's go see what's upstairs, and then we can start doing some more exploring of this place. Nothing special yet. What? See, that's the problem when interact with and shoot is the same button. So I tried to shoot the thing, and instead, I zapped myself with it. That's not at all what I wanted to do. Ugh, tired. Okay, That's all of the symbols I can see so far, so now it's time to explore.
Talk about filthy.
No one's used this for some time.
Talk about filthy.
No one's used this for some time.
You say that.
I think I'm gonna puke.
Oh.
Wand, shoot. Please. I don't know why I... There we go.
Locked.
I was having to shoot manually with control.
Wardrobe. Standard fitting, I suppose.
The claw marks aren't there.
Interesting. Okay.
Wardrobe. Standard fitting, I suppose.
The claw marks aren't there.
Well, now I know that that's a passage through, and I've unlocked both sides of it.
This can't have been the way my father would have left it. Can't be.
If not, the question is, who did?
So, this is supposed to be Adam's father's house? So he lives nowhere. There's a church, this house, and a fence around everything. Have I been through here yet, really? No. Yeah, I would assume that someone else has been in here, considering there's like no furniture for the most part.
Talk about filthy.
No one's used this for some time.
Talk about filthy.
No one's used this for some time.
I think I'm gonna puke.
Oh.
Again, subtitles don't quite match up with what's actually being
locked.
Said. Yeah, just kind of hoping that you could see something in there. Okay, well, let's go downstairs and take a look. I do have a nice big cup of coffee next to me, which I've been hitting up pretty hard. Trying to wake up. Yeah, you know, it's just one of those incidents that you just can't really foresee. There's another mirror. Why the mirrors? I don't want to break this mirror, although I probably should.
These knives are sharp.
Good kitchen knives usually are.
Hell of an observation there. I'd almost say grab one of the knives, but I've got, what, a sword and
Look
a dagger already?
Someone called bug hunters.
So you're telling me yours isn't like this?
Of course not.
Okay, well, there was a key in the fridge.
Someone likes their privacy.
Nothing's gonna smash through that.
Are you kidding? You have a gun that shoots explosives. And the sword might be rusty, but I'm sure you could pry those boards off with it. I think you just gave up a bit too easily. That's another thing that these point-and-click adventure games don't always make sense on. You can't do that. Why not? I mean, I have this tool. Do I have to use the specific tool in order to pry bars off the door? Hello, what do we have here?
Hey, that's us. But I didn't see any cameras.
Do you think someone knew we were coming?
That's actually kind of funny. Uses stuff from the cutscenes, which, you know, why not?
There's a CD in here.
Can't see any others.
There's a CD in here.
Can't see any others.
Great, take the CD out, change the channel.
What the hell?
Future sight. It's the only possible answer.
I guess we're in a rock band.
Wonder why the windows are bricked up.
Who knows? Your father wouldn't have done this, that's for sure.
Not unless he was trying to keep something out. Wonder why the windows are bricked up.
Who knows? Your father wouldn't have done this, that's for sure.
Not unless he was trying to keep something out. Papers and things. Nothing to give anything away.
Drawer's locked.
Okay, that just did something. What did it do?
Flat screen TV.
It just turned the volume off? Is that it, really? I think it's supposed to actually turn the television itself off, but the video is still there. Which means they weren't able to switch the graphics on it. They switched textures before in the same house. Shooting the marks on those hidden doors.
Locked.
Yeah, of course it is. I guess it means that the key I have isn't for that door. Well, there are a few locked doors in here. I have a key now.
Locked.
Also the locked doors in the church, so... key could be for the other building. Bathroom is in here, and it had a locked door in it. Yes, okay. Hello, hello, hello! Open. Big gun. You guys can't go through doors. Sucks to be you. Aw, you pushings. See, in order for these things to be scary, they need to be able to actually get to you. Having them able to walk through doors really is necessary. It's another thing that just makes this game feel incomplete. Like, it's missing some very basic fundamentals for the combat side. The combat almost seems like an afterthought. Which it might be, let's be honest. Okay, that's been taken care of. Another key. You know what? I haven't done in a while. Save again. Oh, you know what? Yeah, I need to keep that in my hand at all times, because those secret green runes don't show up unless I'm holding the flashlight. So, every time I pick up a key, the flashlight gets not dropped per se, but set aside. And since we don't want that to happen right now, okay, is this door unlocked now?
Locked.
Nope. Is that cabinet up there unlocked, perhaps? At this point, I'm finding keys in order to find keys. Yeah, there we go. That I don't particularly care for. Hey, you found a key. What does it get you? Another key. Well, what does that get you? Another key! And now I go check the room downstairs. I think that's the last locked door in this house. Yeah, okay. Oh my god! This wallpaper is hideous! Oh, Jesus! Okay, that I wasn't expecting. Remember, they can walk through stuff. They can walk through chairs, but not through door frames. Hello?
Someone's novel. Father's, maybe.
Maybe not. This book's personal to someone. The aura surrounding it speaks to me of someone other than your father.
Let's pick it up and find out. Great. More reading. Are you ready?
Someone's novel. Father's, maybe.
Maybe not. This book's personal
to someone. The Pit
and
the Pendulum by Edgar Allan Poe.
The aura surrounding it speaks to me of someone other than your father.
God, I would love it if we could actually read that. That's a much better story than this game. I don't think I've ever read that one, to be entirely honest. I've read several Poe pieces.
No bulb. Nothing hidden here, either.
Worth a try.
Yes, Rebecca, it actually was worth
this
a try.
Seen better days.
Bit of a mismatch in here, don't you think?
No,
Nothing down the back.
Let's carry on trying, though.
I think the key, or the...
Nothing down the back.
Let's carry on trying, though.
Okay, as I was going to say, I do think these chairs kind of match each other, so not much of a mismatch there. They kind of match the bookshelf. They don't match the walls, but nothing matches those things. Although, why the specific... I can't find anything in this room stuff. Okay, so that was that door, apparently.
Nothing down the back.
Let's carry on trying, though.
Nothing down the back.
Let's carry on trying, though.
Nothing down...
Let's carry on trying, though.
So, okay, well, that
Someone's
does kind
novel.
Of explain... Okay.
Fathers, maybe.
Maybe not. This book's personal to someone. The aura surrounding it speaks to me of someone other than your father.
A book that burned itself. Okay, so all three... What is this? Nothing I can click.
Someone's novel. Father's, maybe.
Maybe not. This book's
I
personal to someone.
I can't see what book this one is. The title is just a blur. Let's put this back in my hand. But that burned book, the book that lit itself on fire might be useful.
There's something sticking out of the pages.
A key. The perseverance has paid off at last.
I have a feeling this book holds the answer to quite a few questions.
No doubt. Let's go through it. Thoroughly and systematically, okay?
Oh, shit. Here we go again. See, we got another key out of the book. Just like the previous journal. No, this is Claude Valentine's journal. No, it isn't. Because the other one stopped at, like, 15-something. This one's 16... Oh, crap. Okay, volume 2 of Claude Florentine's journal. Yeah, I'm gonna read it. I'm just getting ready. Mostly because these things kind of hurt my eyes. And I need some coffee. Okay, I can do this. Oh, I apologize for doing that on microphone. Here we go with some of the most engaging video you could ever watch. Yes. Some guy trying to read pixelated script in a bad video game. Actually, the video game's not too bad, but I'll get to that later. Here we go. Although all new covenants from the recent London... It looks like most. Although all new covenants from the recent London, most are still among our numbers. Oh! Okay. I shudder to think what has befallen Jean-Claude of Lyon, David of Leicester, and Paul of Durham. Whatever their fate, it must be connected to the disappearance of the Dodger into the Tower. Without guidance, and the correct medicine, the servitor could spell trouble. I am currently collecting together the names of all the few who will be volunteering to don gate devices and track the thing down. I dreamt last night of the sword. Methinks it bears more significance than I originally thought. Certainly, Blyle knows more than he's letting on. God, how many pages is this? Of the 6 acolytes I sent into the tower to hunt the Dodger 3 days ago, none have returned. Vine promptly disappeared into the tower and returned withdrawn with 2 bodies and their respective traveling devices. He has not been the same since. Even Belial cannot understand this change in temperament. Whatever the Dodger has become and how this has occurred remains a mystery even to Vine. My dreams of the sword continue. I feel myself lost in thought on the subject. And this was, what? A couple weeks after the other one. So that was Halloween of 1673. Now we move on to 100 years later, 1783, 1st of October. Tomorrow we break the 5th shard and seal within the chamber of the soul stone. The crossing of the tower will be harder than ever. It seems the Dodger is somehow controlling the ire. The two combined have become troublesome of late, and I fear lives will be lost and blood will be spilt before the ceremony is performed. As a result, I have deliberated not to inform the temple. One more thing, I have discovered that upon each traveling, that someone or something travels to the tower. At one of the tower gates, only yesterday, I discovered a single white feather. Curious. The Dodger, I have decided with Belial and Vine's consultation. To create a small handful of yielders to once and for all rid us of this accursed beast. My dreams of the sword have remained. Last evening, I dreamt of a place, a castle of, a spirit place, where it lay guarded from me. Despite my dream efforts, the sword remained unobtainable. Dude's been dreaming about the sword for 100 years. You know, the story doesn't have to be told over 600 years. Especially since, you know, language changes over time, and 600 years ago, this stuff would not be legible today. Second of October, 1783, so the day after. The shard and seal is broken, and the fragments within my hands, but the yielders have been unsuccessful in their task. One crawled back to me through the pages of the library on fire and died. As I doused the flames, it became clear that it was not the fire that had driven it from its task. In its mouth was a bloody white feather, and about its body were deep marks that could have been made by claws but were not. They were wounds of some blade which would have had to have been enchanted given the precision of the gashes. It is surely not the work of the Dodger. Something lurks within the tower, and I know not what. Last night, in my dreams, I touched the sword and immediately found myself at the Soul Stone. Abaddon was there. Quite unexpectedly, he told me that someone would come, someone who would take his place as Keeper of the Seals, and another, born from the Tree of Life, someone who wielded the sword for me in the last ceremony, or at least destroy utterly our efforts. Supplement. I have placed a single urge upon each gate within the void, with instructions to report any sightings within that place. The 2 feathers I now keep in a safe box. And we jump forward another 100 years to April 15, 1895. 3 days ago, I witnessed an uncharacteristic trait in Belial. When I informed him of the death of the Urges and the Yielders, he took off in blind anger from his place in the library and promptly accessed the tower. He returned at the stroke of midnight, tattered and bloody, only to disappear again, this time into the night without a word. He returned 3 nights later, this evening, creeping silently into the study where I sat awaiting him. He told me that he had failed me, and when I inquired of him of the events of the 12th, he raged and paced the room, muttering incomprehensible words, thumping his fist repeatedly on the walls, till the place literally shook at his touch. Calming himself, Belial leveled a look of despair and informed me that the gardeners had in fact returned to their precious tower despite his promise that they had all perished at the fall of the stone. They were responsible for the deaths. As I write, I know that I must travel the ways, but this time the tower will not be free to allow access. I am therefore prepared to contact my allies. Good, last page. 18th of April, 15th. I don't know why that would change up there, but okay. We are preparing for the assault on the tower. With me will come Belial, Vine, my two head priests, and a disciplined group of 24 dodgers. Each of us mind-controlling 6 of them. That should be enough to get us through the chamber of the Soulstone. We will embark through the tower gate in the Mage in the Graveyard, as it seems the shortest route to the Shoal Mantle. Supplement. Disaster has befallen us. As we walked back along the tower, we were met at the tower gate by the Ire. Leading the cloud was the Dodger we lost so long ago. His eyes gleamed fire, red, and hatred at its inflated body seemed to bristle with power as it leapt from the stone to stand before us. Belial was there in an instant, wrestling with the beast so that the ire moved from the gate. Seizing the opportunity, I commanded everyone to the gate as explosions from the ire rocked the very tower itself. As the two priests transported through the gate, Vine met with Belial and the Dodger to consume them with fire. The three became a molten fireball of burning flesh, but the Dodger was too strong. Vine was thrown toward the gate and immediately disappeared into Helid. Belial was left crawling upon the path, smoking, as I commanded the Dodgers under discipline to attack. With one twist of its head, the Dodger burned them all as they charged. They threw themselves from the path into the eternal blackness, disappearing finally like fireflies in the deep pit. Helping Belial to his feet, I seized the opportunity and used the gate to take us to safety. The last thing I remember was stepping to Helid as a single white feather dropped to my feet. I put it with the other two and threw the box in the hiding place.
I wonder if the gardener that Florentine mentions in the journal is Raphael. Or is it one of the others? Raphael did say he...
If it is, it means that he's...
We've already heard that one. In fact, we've heard pretty much all of these.
Evidently, the gardener that Florentine mentions in his journal is Raphael.
On return from the tower, Belial told Florentine that the gardeners had returned, and that they were responsible for the deaths of the demons guarding the gates.
It would seem that Raphael did have some friends.
Now, I'm wondering what the Dodgers are.
The journal mentions the One Power. He's talking about God?
The opposite. Florentine makes a reference to
that. We've used that. That was from the previous one. So
this temple business. Anything in the journal? Anything I've missed?
Seems to be some sort of religious order. According to the journal, there were more than just acolytes working for Florentine. It mentions powers, dark powers.
Okay. Again, those were from the previous journal. Now, I do once again have another hole, another key. So let's get my flashlight out. That must be the key to the church. So let's save again. Now that you guys have had some just riveting discussion with the journals. Hello. Oh, those might be Dodgers. I think those are the Dodgers, to be honest. If you kind of move sideways to them, even their bullets don't actually hit you. Because they have a travel time, too. Whew, that one did hit me. Oh, crap, I'm hurting. Oh, I am hurting. I don't have many healing potions left either. Oh god, you're still alive. Oh, come on! Okay. Remember, this is it for my healing potions, so I am worried. Okay. But obviously I must have gotten what I needed, or they wouldn't be sending more things after me. Which, you know, is backed up by the fact that, yes, I can access the bell tower here. Don't know what that is! It's a tiara.
This is delicate.
Be careful with it.
Great, I've just been crowned Miss America. Bell tower. Can I ring the rope? No. Look! Another key! That's gonna get me into the other room where I've already kind of looked at stuff. Can I... No, I can't do anything with the key or the rope. No bell ringing for me. No Quasimodo here. Save the game again. The coffee has begun to take a little bit of effect anyway. Caffeine, my precious friend, how I missed thee. Just to make sure.
Knight, or some soldier. Definitely Norman period, though.
You're not the idiot I first took you for, are you?
No, but he's an idiot.
The angel.
See, there's
looks
Michael.
Similar to the one in the window, don't you think?
Very similar.
Alrighty.
Hmm. What's that discolored ring around the Madonna's head?
You know, I'm not sure. Perhaps the discoloration's something to do with the stone?
There's a small indentation here. Looks like a fern or something.
Hmm.
No, they're feathers.
There's a small There's a small indentation.
Okay. I have two feathers. It keeps putting that one on. I think I want to put the other one on. Where is the other feather? There, see? And the tiara. Which is apparently a very tiny tiara. More of Alf's armor? Hello, Michael!
We meet again. This time through the dragon head.
But I already have a helmet that gives me info on you.
Smashed over the back of the head, right? Actually, no. It is a passport to Athen.
There we go.
Put it on, lad. Yourself if that were the case. But beware. Aqua is the most beautiful of all the realms. It is far too easy for you to lose your purpose there.
Point taken.
He
Still haven't said when we need to go there at all. I had various clues in all of them.
But the clues have not become fact. You remember when we first met? I spoke in metaphors.
Sure.
And my words.
You first told me to go with open eye. And that's Rebecca. And the second was, go with the wings of angels to guide me?
That must be the feather.
Well?
She is correct. It was the feather that brought you to me, and to the dragon house.
It was kind of obvious, though.
Next.
Something about my voyage to the tower.
Okay, you are correct. And the final metaphor.
Something about dragons.
The sword of the dragon.
Yeah, sword of the dragon.
Held aloft as a beacon to the tower. That was it, wasn't it?
It was the sword of the dragon.
Eternity. The sword that was taken from the Soulstone by Florentine, the sword that started all of this. That's what you mean, isn't it?
And now you must take it to the chamber of the Soulstone, at the heart of all things. The ultimate destinies of you both lie upon Shiro. Trust your senses. Walk carefully within the divine realm, and more carefully still when you come to the gates of hell.
Okay. Am I on a new chapter now? I think so. Yep. Chapter 13, Sword of the Dragon. There are 20 chapters in the game. I found this out when I was looking up how long I needed to be here. Take the items back. Oh, look, healing! Thank God! Okay, so we are in a new chapter. We are finally moving forward again. So, the Sword of the Dragon is Eternity. I'm going to find it in the Divine Realm. I then put the Shrive, onto the pommel. I can then find my passage into Shoal, where I stick the sword into the Soulstone and either save or damn the world. So I know what to do. Just don't know how. And isn't that always the case?
Combine the face with the soul.
You know what? I'm not going to yet.
To walk the tower. Know that you stand before the tower. Possess the right of passage.
I'm not going to yet because I remembered something. I haven't been down here yet. Okay, well, there's a dude down there. Is that the only one? Missed. Open the door, please. That one hit. It doesn't seem very good at actually coming and getting me. Nope, there is another one. Okay. I forgot to do that again. Let it charge. So those things are perfectly capable of coming and getting me as long as there's nothing in the way that stops them. The AI in this game is not particularly well done, which should not come as a surprise. And there's a couple of them there, you see? Now that it doesn't have to try to climb stairs and get all confused that it can't walk in a straight line. Awesome! Okay, so what's in this wine cellar? Something I'm going to need, clearly. A big door with a big lock on it. Those candelabra. Aha! You see? You see? That's why I put the wand on! Or the glasses, I mean. Hello! I don't want to play with you. be okay shooting you, though. Or not. Maybe. Can you attack me through there?
Thing seems to be caught in some ward. Someone's keeping it here. That's for sure.
Okay, well, whatever. I don't like seeing enemies around. Because if it gets out, it's going to try to kill me, and I don't want it to try to kill me.
Beer keg. Could use some of that right now.
You and me both, pal.
Beer keg. Could use some of that right now.
I don't think I'm going to find anything on any of these shelves. I'm going to look, though. Because it's an adventure game, and there's always something hidden. And it's always hidden somewhere I don't find, as you saw earlier yesterday. Something so obvious as move the doormat. Well, I didn't even see the bloody doormat. Well, I'm not seeing anything I can react to. You know how it goes, pixel hunt. Anywhere my cursor changes. No cursor changes. So, there's the hidden door. Well, let's take a look at this.
There's some sort of lock mechanism built into this. Locked.
Yeah, I don't have a key for that. But, there's a door right here that I know of. Let's go see what's through it. Dun dun dun. Ha! 2D pixels. Hello?
Someone's keeping busy.
I can sense something in here. Magical. Very concentrated.
I don't know. Could be a secret passage.
What was that? What is that? What did I just pick up?
Key. Floral design.
The key of life. I'm in uncharted territory. This is cool. No.
No secret door yet.
Of all the places we've looked, this is probably the most likely.
We've looked in two places. Two. Oh, thank God. Any more healing vials in here? No. Dang it. Yeah. Dang it. It was a good hiding place for one, too. I liked that.
Nothing yet. Nothing at all. No. Don't think there's a door here after all. No. Don't think there's a door here after all. No. Don't think there's a door here after all. No. Don't think there's a door here after all. No. Don't think there's a door here after all. No. Don't think there's a door here after all. No. Don't think there's a door here after all.
I think there is.
No. Don't think there's a door here after all. No. Don't think there's a door here after all. No. Don't think there's a door here after all.
Anything under the tables? Not that I see. Ah, what do we have here? We have a nothing!
Beer keg.
Random discoloration
Could
for no reason.
That right now? No. Don't think there's a door here after all.
Well, okay. Well, he's telling me there's no secret doors anywhere.
No. Don't think there's a door here after all.
I have a feeling that if there was a door, it wouldn't be an eyeball thing. It'd be a... you can interact with this thing. And again, I'm not seeing my cursor change to that, so... there probably is a secret door in here. I'm just not finding it. I think it has less to do with bookshelves and more to do with the... Oh, look at that! Whoops, texture. That is the texture of the floor. In fact, if I were to stand directly on top of it, I bet it lines up perfectly. It does. You can see it comes right across the middle there. Whoops. Do the others have that too? Yes, they do. Look at that. I wonder if that's a clue of some sort.
No. Don't think there's a door here after all.
I wonder if that's a clue, seriously. Because, I mean, look, it's... That's the floor. Although that's actually over here. Speaking of the floor, since I never do look down when I need to, how about this rug? No, nothing on the rug. Nothing with these papers. I suppose it would be a little too obvious to do that twice in a row. What's up with the texture on the books? No idea. Let's go see if that key opens the door. Yes, it does. Now I have access to a garden.
What the hell? Hey, what is this place?
I've no idea. But it's an image we're looking at. It's not really here. See how it's shifting?
Are you sure it's an image?
What the hell? Hey, what is this place?
I've no idea. But it's an image we're looking at. It's not really here. See how it's shifting?
It'll probably come into play later. Three. I'm wondering if this comes into play when we get to heaven. Divine. It's not really heaven. Okay, well, that was a thing. Is there a tree symbol back in here, in this room? Is there anything tree-like other than that bush? I don't see one. Okay, well, I've done what I can in this room. Pardon me while I take my allergy pills. I'm off to a very late, slow, bad start this morning. I apologize. That was necessary. Eyes are starting to water. Hi.
Thing seems to be caught in some ward. Someone's keeping it here, that's right. For sure.
So, theoretically, I can go to the tower from that spot now? Oops, wrong way. So here we are, my father's house, and my father's church, which has this fence around all of it, and nothing beyond the fence. Video games don't make any sense.
Stuck fast. Tower gate.
Magical portal.
Apparently the helmet is now glued to the portal.
Combine the face with the soul traveler.
Boom! Mind blown. Alrighty, now what have we got? Believe we were looking for the divine. I believe we've seen the divine, because this place looks awfully familiar, considering there's corpses around. I do have a map of the tower. I'm not using it, but I have a map of the tower. That's not where I want to go. No, this staircase leads back to the realm of the spirit. That I remember. Oh, okay, you know what gate this is? That's the one that had the cross on it before. So that means that that's how to get back to my father's place. Gotcha. Then that would mean what the cross was. I'm honestly surprised I can remember anything about this game. Usually I forget stuff very quickly. Like why I'm talking. No one's listening to me. Oh my god, I'm recording! Okay, that was stupid. But I am stupid. You've seen me. this should be the right way to the divine, now that I have a helmet that's stuck on the ground back there. What the hell? Nothing left attacking me, either. I've never seen this ire thing.
I will avenge and kill the son of Adam.
Avenge and kill. That makes no sense.
Know that you approach the divine realm. Traveler, you possess the rite of passage. Go now with the song to guide you.
And here goes nothing.
To which the laws that govern he has decreed. Nothing can be brought to this realm that parallels the law. All possessions that mirror the elements have been ruled unfit. They will be returned at your departure. Further, only one device exists that may be taken from this realm. The Sword Eternity. You are marked, son of Adam. But are you truly worthy? Let it begin.
So, I have a trial in front of me. And everything else has been removed. I bet all my weapons are gone, too.
Scroll. Vellum, isn't it?
Yes, animal hide.
Traveler, welcome. Since you are reading this, you must be the Chosen in search of the Sword of the Dragon Eternity. This is Arquia, the Divine, Realm of Purity and Peace. This is what you must do. All four elements must be in their absolute state. This may require you to use one element to produce another from the raw ingredients that you have found. Take the four elements to the Ring of Eight and place them correctly. They will conjure the presence of the Hafraza. When you look upon the face of Tristra, take up the elements again and combine them. Remember that what pleases us often pleases the divine also, and consider which of your senses is as yet untouched. When the scent of success sweetens the air, you will achieve your mind's desire. So clues that at the moment don't mean anything. All I have is a scroll. I have no weapons. I have no items. Yep, this took everything from me. As to be expected. And the only thing I can take back from here is the sword. Honestly, I approve of this. This is interesting. I'm gonna walk around the gate just to be sure. There's nothing else. I have no healing potions either, yes. Oh, I hope there's no combat. Because all I have is fists. Maybe I should have used another healing potion before coming in. I don't know yet. And if I do get any healing potions here, I'll probably want to use them before leaving. I'm just making sure there's nothing on the outer edge. There's four doors on the inside, at least three so far. I'm just checking the outer edge, that's all. I want to be thorough. Alright, I see nothing. I will walk all the way back to the portal just to make sure. Yep, four doors. Probably corresponding with the four elements.
Water is clear as crystal.
Anything in there?
Good question. If I fall down there, though, I drown. Now, if I go... Okay, the other gate's there. I was honestly wondering if... How cool would it have been if each of these gates takes me to a different building. Like, entirely. If the inside is completely different on all four. Which, theoretically, it could still do, but I doubt that. This place is going to be a total mystery for a long time.
Wow. This is incredible.
You're telling me.
It's also not what we're looking for, dude. Don't get enthralled by the looks of it all. But you were very specifically warned about that.
Some mosaic or something.
There's power at work here. Powers of transportation and movement. But we're at the end of it.
Okay. You'll also notice that these things have colors on
them. Curious design.
There's a trace of power connected to this. Faint, but they're all the same.
Red, fire. I am upstairs now. What do I find?
Piece of flint.
Might come in handy later. I can't sense any magic from it, though.
Okay, that's flint. I also need steel or the like.
A magnifying glass would be handy right now.
Damn. Stuck fast.
Yes, a magnifying glass would be nice. And I had one, but they took it away from me.
Steel cylinder.
Use the flint and we've got a spark. Fire. One of the elements we lack here.
Indeed. Now, let's try making a fire right here. Why? Because why not?
Steel cylinder.
Use the flint and we've got a
piece of flint.
Might come in handy.
No,
later.
No. I pick that up. There, see? Now I got flint and steel.
This one's stuck fast.
A magnifying glass would be handy right now.
Now I have flint and steel. What do we have here?
Some optical design. Can you sense anything, Rebecca?
It's definitely some sort of teleporter. Where it goes, well, there's only one way to find out.
Curtain of light. Not gonna let us through.
No, I don't think it will. The ward's a hybrid of the magic of passing and the magic of stasis. Something to do with the water element also.
Okay, so that one's water. How about this one?
Curtain of light. Not gonna let us through.
No, I don't think it will.
Okay, so they're all water elements.
The ward's a hybrid of the magic of passing and the magic of stasis. Something to do with...
What's this meant to symbolize?
Colors gold, wouldn't you say?
Okay.
Can't
well,
make
water.
This any ideas?
No, not really.
It's pretty universally water there. There's fire.
I almost hear you thinking.
Okay, well, let's go... Can I... There we go. I have to touch it to use it, apparently. So I have flint and steel. I can make fire, in theory. So, of course, the Book of Matches is gone. I need fire, Flick. Okay, that's cheating. Yeah, well, whatever. Magnifying glass! Is there anything else down there?
This tile's different from the others.
Yeah, that was why I could click it, dude. Alright. So, to be entirely honest, I kind of like this place. This is pretty neat. Another hole here. Just making sure, you know, gotta be thorough. Check all the corners. I'm not gonna jump down there, though. No way out here. What happens if I fall in that area, then? Well, I guess I teleport back now. That magnifying glass, so I can go use the magnifying glass in that one area. Oh, really?
Curtain of light. Not gonna let us through.
No, I don't think it will. The ward's a hybrid of the magic of passing and the magic of stasis.
So I could go out, but I can't go back in. Oh, game, you're so silly. Okay, what do we got here? We got something else. So let's check out where this goes. I'm gonna guess Earth. You know, a gold square, I'm gonna assume, is the Earth element area. First, I thought I was in the fireplace again, but no. What do we have here? Water. Ow. Don't fall. Don't fall, dude. I can't take that much damage. I have no healing. Now, the water makes me think I can do this.
Metal flask. There's a fine red powder inside.
Keep it close, Adam. It's very magical.
Don't know what teleporter this is.
Metal bowl and black powder. Any ideas?
About the bowl, no. The powder's even stranger. It's of no substance I've ever come across.
Magical?
Goes without saying. One thing. This is incomplete. It needs something else.
Probably the red powder that I have?
Metal flask.
Keep it close, Adam.
Okay.
It's snow. The powder's changed to snow.
Odd. The two powders must have been catalysts for each other.
Interesting. Well, I have a magnifying glass now, so let's see
this
what it says.
This one's stuck fast.
Grind!
Won't budge.
Grind. Shouldn't be too difficult. I just need something to grind with.
Wow.
You're telling me. I couldn't at first. But the more I concentrate, the more power seems to channel itself and water through me.
Yeah. I can feel it. It's almost as if the water's alive.
Okay. Ah, we have a mortar and a pestle here.
Pestle for grinding.
We need a mortar to use that.
Well, okay, just the pestle. But I thought the mortar we had was the bowl, unless this is the mortar.
Mortar. We've got a pestle somewhere, right?
Usually the two are inseparable and useless without each other.
So, I'm wondering if I'm supposed to grind the snow.
Stuck fast. This blue tile. I can read it now. Bong? What does that mean?
Your guess is as good as mine.
420, blaze it! No. No. Bong probably means use some kind of chime. What's this one? Is this the one? Yeah, okay, this is the one that had the flint and steel.
Something written here. Burn?
Obviously, this is the, that was the fire one. That would be that earth. That's probably air. Oh! Nothing. That's a strange one. What have we here? Okay, now it's probably air.
Nothing hidden here.
Oh! Alrighty then. Let's read this.
Scroll. Something there.
Burn.
Can't make it out though.
A magnifying glass would be handy right now.
Okay, well, first off...
Pestle for grinding.
No.
Might come in handy.
Do that.
Paper fan. Oriental.
The design's the yin and the yang.
Really? Okay, so I can either try to burn the snow... Well, hold on. The magic items.
Magnifying glass. Gold?
Definitely. No inherent magical qualities, though.
Something written here. Burn?
Burn. flint and steel. Okay, let's go back to where it asks me to burn. I'm going to fill up the glass anyway. So it asks me to burn. No, let's grind. That's not what I want. I could probably grind the snow. Burn is on the opposite side. So I've got paper that wants me to burn it, and I got flint and steel.
Piece of flint.
Use the flint, and we've got a spark. Whoa, that seems to have done something.
Okay, but what?
Something written here, Draw.
There we go. What do we have here? Tinder.
Salts. It's tinder. Very combustible in this form.
Straw?
Of sorts. It's tinder. Very combustible in this form.
Okay, so I have tinder, I have flint, I have steel. Let's put the tinder down there, and let's burn it. No, put the tinder down.
Straw?
Of sorts. It's tinder. Very combustible in this form.
Let's pick the tinder up. Can I do this? Stop. There.
Straw?
Of sorts. It's tinder. Very combustible in this form.
I have fire. You want bong. I have no idea what that one is yet. You want grind, which, let's take a look.
Water pipe. A hookah, if I'm not mistaken.
Oriental tobacco pipe.
Yeah. Tried one once. Principle's that the smoke's drawn up through the water in the vase area from whatever's being burned.
Whatever being the operative word.
Okay, maybe we did find the bong! Bong.
Won't budge.
Do I combine this with something?
Open. Good.
I literally have no idea what I just did. But it made noise.
Fossil resin.
Okay, let's grind the amber. There we go. No.
Hey, what's this?
I think it used to be burned as incense.
I'm getting close. Grind. Which one had grind? Not you. You're already open, so you over here had grind. No, you had the hookah. I have no idea. Let's pick that back up, because at this point, I'm wondering if I should put the incense in the bong.
Maybe later.
No, stop clicking the wrong button.
Maybe later.
I don't know how that made noise. I really don't.
Maybe later.
Why? Why later?
Maybe later.
Okay, well let's put that. No, that's not what I want. If you're gonna do that, you go on air. You're gonna go on water. You are gonna go on earth. And the last one, the fire, let's put it back and see what happens.
Time to put the offering together, I think.
Wow. This is incredible.
You're telling me.
Can you sense anything unusual from this, Rebecca?
I couldn't at first. But the more I concentrate, the more power seems to channel itself and water through me.
Yeah. I can feel it. It's almost as if the water's alive.
Alright. What the hell am I supposed to do? Where's the hookah? Can't use the water pipe. Use the flint and steel with the water pipe? How does that make a bong sound? Yes. How does using fire with the water pipe make a bong? I swear, if that's what they were going for, if that's the joke... it's now time to put the offerings together. So, let's...
maybe later.
Okay, water pipe with water. With mortar. Okay, well, it's burning. I've made the incense.
Gods don't pick things up for themselves, Adam.
I guess I offer it to the water. Yes, smoke that incense. This has officially become one of the most bizarre things I've ever done. The gods just want to get high.
Dragon sword.
Rebecca, that look in your eyes troubles me. I don't have the shive with me yet. I have to wait till I get back out.
Eternity. Now we're finally going to get some answers.
Chapter 14? Chapter 14, please. Chapter 14. Yes! Vengeful souls! We are booking! I don't think there's anything left to do here, is there? Can I get back out through these? I don't know about you guys, but I did mostly like that puzzle. The whole flint plus water pipe equals gong? What the hell?
This connects with the pavilion.
The one in the garden, yes. But it's only one way.
So the other one must go downstairs. Thank you. This one? Yeah, this one.
Strange design. Anything?
Probably a transporter.
Here we go. Back to the pavilion. Alright, now what's going to pop out and try to kill me? Well, I guess nothing in the divine will. I hope. No, no. Well, Let's pick a direction and go. Yeah, it would have been faster to go diagonally from one door to another. It looks like I hit the right way anyway. Said something else.
Combine the face with the soul traveler.
He said something else.
To walk the tower. Know that you stand before the tower and possess the right of passage. Combine the
Yeah, right here he says something, but I keep it like there's such a small trigger between it and the other trigger that I don't see what's being said, and I want to see what's being said. Okay, let's approach slowly.
The mask and the traveler are one together. Come closer. Walk unto the gate. The mask and
whatever.
Combine the face with the soul traveler.
Now, when I get back out here, I should have my stuff back, which had better include the shrive. Because I have a feeling that they could just go, oh, hey, your stuff got stolen while we were here. Nope, okay, good. Shrive, where are you? Shrive.
So now we have Eternity, the dragon sword. This thing's as light as a feather, you know?
Death, Adam, is as light as a feather. Duty is as heavy as a rock. Use it well.
Thank you.
So it won't actually let me combine them right away.
All we have to do is take the dragon sword to the Chamber of the Soul Stone.
Not going to be an easy trip, that's for sure.
All you have to
At
do?
Last.
No.
Eternity. This is why I've been brought here. Everything has been leading to this. The sword of Florentine's dreams. The sword of the dragon. I can feel its power. Its energy. It's part of me. But there's another. I can feel their energy connecting with mine. The swords. Who can it be? So close.
Okay, let's see. I can't actually combine those two yet. It won't let me. Let's do this. Swap those around. And Eternity will go into that slot. I'm going to save the game. Yes, we are so close. Except that we're not. Because you can't put the shrive in the sword, even though I know I have to. The game currently will not let me. Don't you hate it when you're smarter than the game? Nope, almost fell off the edge of the world there. That would have been bad. I hope that's a sword humming and not the world. I also don't think I have a passage into Shoal yet. That's a good point. I don't know where the entrance to Shoal even is. Suppose I could look at my map. Let's do that. Where's my map? Where is my map of the tower? Complete. There's okay, that's the symbol for Shoal. That's Arkwale, which we just came out of, so that would be the church over there. That would be Requiem over there. There, you see the problem. Now, I can get back to here. But in order to get to Shoal, I have to come from here. You can't get there from here. So I have to find my way to there in order to get out to get to Shoal. So, pardon me.
The Templars come. Look there, above the mount. The legions of darkness that come to me. To me. Rally to the banner.
Wow. Yeah, there are demons all over the place now. That hurt more than I really needed it to. I'm too hurt on life to really afford to melee with a sword when those things can kind of wreck me when I do that. So, I need a new tactic. But the forces of darkness are starting to wage against me. I'm betting I have to go back to the manor at this point. There's a whole lot of... Remember, there's a lot of teleporters back in the manor that for some reason or other weren't working. I'm gonna go this way again. I think I went this way last time. Because that way leads where I don't want to go. So... This is one of those where I bet they can't actually cross. Oh, no, I'd gone the other direction.
Stand for the light. Rally to the walls and fight.
Now, can you reach me if I go back through the portal or through the wall back here? Can you get through that barrier? No, you cannot. Can I shoot through the barrier? You see, these things aren't a threat. No, I can't. These things really aren't a threat to you if you can make yourself safe like this. And he's just going to turn around and walk away. I'll run forward. I will shoot him. He will run back to me. I think this is how you're supposed to play, to be entirely honest. Because remember, the combat in this is an afterthought. I want this.
With the fires of wrath, he shall consume.
Wrath. It's not wrath. Dude. Alright, well, this guy's gonna be more trouble than the other one was. Very specifically, more trouble than the other one was. Or I could zap him with just everything, pick up more health. Oh, I love these enemies. I want more of them. As you see now, though, I've got all these weapons that are basically infinite ammo, but they have a recharge time. So I'm kind of having to cycle through them, which is harder than it sounds, because I have to hit the specific controls for it. Whoops. Oh, crap! That was not good. Oh, I forgot they can do things like fall. That was scary. That was very scary. But I got more healing, which I need. Now that guy I can hopefully snipe from a distance. Gun says no. Nah, it's not gonna let me shoot that one.
He plots against me. His vision is great, but my will is the stronger.
Who are you? Guy's been talking and talking and talking, and I still have no idea who he is. Who he's supposed to be. Boink. Ah, don't fall and take damage, you idiot. And then I come over here and nothing, so that's where I really need to be is what I was. Oh, here's a different path. Alright, that's where I think I'm supposed to be going, because there's the way back to the mansion. Can I shoot you? Yes, I can. As such, I'm going to snipe you. Best I can, anyway. Well, that one's down. I can't get to his health, but back to the mansion. Health should remain there. Oh, cutscene. Yay! Ooh, that's the ire. No, it's not. It's just clouds. Uh-oh.
Adam, help me. For the love of God, help me.
A little late for your father now, wouldn't you say, Adam? Cup's certainly run out over. Not to mention his veins. His only hope really is you, and there you are with your hands tied behind your back. Metaphorically speaking, that silly girl, loving son watching his father being beaten, humiliated. You have made this a very personal battle.
He's already dead.
Well, what are you going to do, Adam?
Okay, you bastard.
No!
Let's do it.
Adam.
You fool! The Prisoner. It's not a new chapter, just The Prisoner. You fool! Your father's already dead! This is stupid! You are stupid! The longer you delay in saving the world, the longer you delay saving your father. It doesn't really matter what's happening to him in the meantime.
Well then,
What's going on? Where am I?
You are in my hands, as indeed are these.
Shit.
Quiet. Now I'm going to look after your father. You can watch if you like.
Oh, you idiot! And yet, I still have all my other weapons. Belial, you are not good at this. Let's actually shift everything over back to where it was. Shotgun. And in the meantime, staff. Idiot, 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 idiot. Alright, what does it say?
The supremacists of Revelation. More religious baloney.
Religious leaders of a new fundamental movement in Africa claim to have discovered the truth behind the mystery known as the crop circle phenomenon. They ascribe the occurrence not to bizarre and as of yet undetermined freak metallurgical conditions, nor do they believe they are the result of UFOs, crop circles. One report would have us believe are a direct link between Earth as a focal point for the devil. With each successive appearance of the circle, the religious movement known as the Supremacists of Revelation believe that the devil is able to take one step closer from his firing home to the day when he will inevitably manifest himself in the world. The Western Church denies these claims to be true and insisting that the supremacists are religious or a dangerous fundamental movement which strive to power through the unjust and irreverent representation or irreverent interpretation of Holy Scripture. Truth or fiction, these circleists nationwide remain unspoken on the latest theory. Bah. Okay, I tried reading that one a little too fast. Hello. Ironically, my hands are in his same position. Unintentionally. Don't you just love the pixelization here where the screen is constantly moving around even when he isn't? Just because of the encoding? This predates things like DivX encoding, which... DivX is amazing encoding. We had so much problem looking for good video encoding.
Rebecca? Rebecca?
Where are you?
Well, I've no idea. I'm in a cell somewhere.
There's no need to shout. The Vector's letting us talk. It's invisible to Belial. But it won't stop you getting hurt.
Yes, but Rebecca, he's got the sword, the key, the shrine. He's wearing those gloves again. That's where we can hold the damn thing.
I don't give up. I'll try and get to you. In the meantime, see what you can do.
And those gloves are implied to be made of skin of some buddy or something that was worthy of holding the staff or the sword, which is cool.
Hell. These sheets are filthy.
Anyway, as I was saying, video encoding. Nowadays, video encoding is so beautifully done. I mean, you can compress video quite nicely. Hello, I'm trying to read things. I'm trying to talk, actually.
You right?
Yeah, I think so. You?
Yeah, fine. Should we go?
Belial's taken all our things.
I can't sense him on this run. He must have taken them through the tower.
But you have all your weapons! You... Okay, chapter 15. Where the dead lie. Did we hit chapter 14 yet? Is it gonna be another one of those? Save the game. Video encoding. Again, let's try that one more time. Nowadays, we have things like YouTube, Netflix, all this wonderful streaming audio, which, yes, we have more bandwidth. But some of the original video encoding had to be stuff like RealPlayer and some pretty cheap Flash, which did have video encoding, yes. Kind of crappy. I mean, YouTube has helped increase it better and better. But, man, real video. You guys don't remember, those who don't remember RealPlayer and how absolutely terrible that looked to some of the earliest streaming video. That's all we had. That's why, you know, video compression, DivX was kind of a holy grail of video compression. It's like the MP3 of video. It was really good. And that's what we'd been looking for quite a while. So, yeah. Stuff. I'm going to read all of these because I can.
Surgeon, what's this about?
I wonder if it's got anything to do with...
Oh, great, she's back. Three of France's most noted and distinguished medical dermatological surgeons are still reported as missing after a three-week absence from their respective hospital practices in Lyon, Vertilly, Francisco, and Bonn. The puzzle continues. Curse is the same size as the other one. I'm going to read all of these.
I wonder if that's where Florentine got the equipment for his observatory.
Too much of a coincidence, isn't it?
Noted astronomer dies in house to blaze. Titled astronomer Sir Henry Godwin tragically died last night in a fire which spread through the entire west wing of his home in rural Gloucestershire. Police fear foul play as various astrological apparatuses and other equipment was found to be missing from his private observatory, according to his wife, Elise, who was stated as having slept through the fire and the arrival of the local fire brigade. Good God! Punctuation! I don't need a sentence that long. Look at this. Here's the start of the sentence. There's the end of the sentence. Half of this freaking article is one sentence. Scotland Yard are continuing the investigation. Their spokesman will issue the statement later today for the press.
Six local women feared missing. I never read about that.
The paper it's printed on is very old.
The people in the rural parish of St. Michael's, Cornwall, have recently reported the bizarre and unexplained disappearance of six local women who vanished within the same hour on the same night 2 days ago. Local sources say that most of the women were not acquainted. Police have taken statements from the families of the missing. There are no signs of a struggle in any of the cases. Police are continuing their investigations.
This mentions my father.
24-hour mystery probe. What happened on the day of the 6th of December? It's St. Nicholas Day. Hey, I know trivia! That's what the people in the parish of St. Michael's near Helston in Cornwall are asking. Isn't there a St. Michael's Day too? Wouldn't it be more interesting to have it done on that date? At any rate. Local Post reporter Martin Kloon was one of the 500-plus residents to have experienced this phenomenon, in which all the residents claimed to have slept through from the evening of the 5th right the way through the morning of the 7th. Local priest, Father Randall of St. Michael's, called together all parishioners for a service on the evening of the 7th for a prayer service to calm people's fears. Local sources indicate that the people of St. Michael's are now coming to terms with the loss. So they lost a day. I wonder if the day has any significance or if it's just random. Probably just random. All the days in this seem to be random. I mean, hell, they had Halloween for one of them.
Europe.
They had Halloween for one of the dates. Didn't mean anything. Reports of a series of fires in homes and estates around Europe are continuing to baffle those involved in the investigations. More than 20 fires have consumed some of the most historical and valuable homes in the East States. Homes and estates in Europe in the space of 2 days. Respective police departments are reluctant to say at this time the incidents are related in any way. Investigations continue around Europe. I would say there's a pattern and that they would probably be related. Really? I guess she opened the door already, so... I thought she opened this door, though. So if she opened this door, how does the other door open? How are all the doors open? Here's... Yes, stuff. Let's see what that is. That is Map of the Graveyard Maze. That will Shoal. There's a portal to Shoal in here somewhere. Well, that's probably going to come in handy later. Yeah, I saw a book. They took all our stuff. No, they didn't. Oh, God!
Hey, what's this? Is this the source of the magic you detected?
Okay.
Hey, what's this? Is this the source of the magic you detected?
Yes. It's a strong healing salve.
Okay, well, I have more healing now. But now I have to do something that I totally and absolutely do not want to do. Read another bloody journal. Is there a key in this one also? No key this time. Entry, 3rd July, 1929. I'm going to see how many pages this is. 1, 2, 3. Oh, good. Just 3 pages. Well, 1929, we're actually at the point of the letters from the very beginning of the game now, so... Damn the beast. Damn it to internal light. How can my mind have created such a creature? The bastard has destroyed the homes and libraries of most of the temple's most influential and affluent members. It must be the beast. It must be. It's too much of a coincidence for it to be anything else other than that damned dodger. Perhaps I will kill it someday. It has taken away from me so much, and in its place left hatred, contempt, and the burning desire to destroy it any way I can. And I will mark this supplement. I must learn to quell my rage. It only fuels the Dodger more. The Dodger is I, and I the Dodger. We are one. I knew this when it attained substance. I must know it now. A strange man visited my dreams again last eve. This time his face was revealed to me. In some way he is, or will be, connected with the church in the village. Could he be the one who will wield the sword of the last rite? In the last rite? 2nd of December. The day of the 6th quickly approaches. Belial. Must I know, reconsider my allegiance? Must I reconsider my allegiance with my old friend? I'm wondering if that's a typo, if that's supposed to be now. Anyway, is it I who owe him, or is it he that must pay the debt? Without him, I would not be here at all. No, it cannot be this. Our goals are surely the same. What has it all come to? I rarely see my old friend these days, anyway. Lest even the chance arise that I may speak to him. Yet he has changed. And always the... Alliance. No. Enticence? No idea. The first few letters of this are very blurred for me. I have no idea. This I should be familiar with, but it disturbs me greatly. When I do chance by him, he is pored over some tome or grimoire, fanatically etching out arcaneries and symbols. I must not question Belial's loyalty. I must promise myself this, despite what the power believes. The years of solitude and the binding to this place must have taken its toll at some point. April 18th of 1895 sticks out of my mind. That, if I remember well, was the day Belial took on the Dodger and barely escaped. I had never seen him like that before nor since. Yes, that must be it. I am sure of it. The Dodger hounds both he and I. Who or what will rid us of this damned beast? All preparations for the breaking of the 6th shard and seal are almost complete. With the breaking of the 6th, the 7th will at last be revealed to us. The one power grows impatient. Soon, yes, very soon it will be done. The wait has been long. For me, it is almost 600 years. But the power of the Morning Star, it has been much longer. 29th of August, 1912. It's going backwards now? I have not seen Belial for 3 months now. Where is he? I need him for the rite of... in perception tomorrow. If all goes well, I will be able to create 12 statues. No. 12 slanderers? For my use around the grounds. They have been far too many people moving close to the area of late, and we need a little protection. The field that these creatures generate when in close proximity to each other will lead to a cloaking of the house and temple. Hopefully the house will not appear to exist, and neither will any compulsion to walk the grounds. Despite our efforts, the creature we captured in the chamber of the Soulstone refuses to speak. Raziel now has him under the key. Belial believes him to be one of the Watchers, the legendary race of Elhim, but I am unsure. The dreams of the sword have returned again. This time my love is connected with them. She's in the chamber with a stranger and the sword together. I could not tell who held the sword aloft. Standing as they are between the Soulstone and myself, she wore a face of anguish. Now that's troubling, especially troubling the fact that that journal entry is actually earlier than the ones that came before it. But that kind of makes me wonder if Rebecca there is not quite on my side. But Michael told me to follow her. Go with open eye. And so I shall. Oh, God. No, done. Thank you. This is fun. I can just close the door. Open it. Shoot. Close it. This is pathetic. He's trying to shoot me through the door, too.
Bone. Looks human.
It is.
Lovely. Okay, is there anything under any of these? Not that I see. Is this a room where they keep the corpses? Oh, okay, so that's why I mapped the graveyard. I was apparently in said graveyard. So let's do that real quick. And I am probably right here. Now, where do I want to go? Left hand would take me to that. Are there any symbols on this map saying that, yes, I want to be here? Okay, well, if I left hand, I go there. And I do want to check that place out. Left hand would lead me to this room, and then it would lead me not at all where I want to go. Okay. Well, let's go find out what's over there. God damn. I need to not be taking so dang much damage. Oh my God! Look at how many of these things there are. Let me back in. Seriously, what the hell? Oh god, he could actually come into this room. Okay, that's not good. I want out. So they can make it through the double doors. I have a bunch of healing now. Might as well use some of it, you know? I am probably not going to make it all the way to the next chapter. Nope, I hit the thing too. Okay, oh god! Damn it, another one. Move sideways to them. Sideways to them. Got him! Alrighty. Yeah, I do hate to say this. I'm gonna have to go before too long. I'm probably not... You know, now is actually a good time to go ahead and just pause it before I dive into this maze. So I will back out to here. This game is taking quite a while. I do apologize for that, but... it's a, you know, point-and-click adventure game. What slows you down with the... combat. And the fact that I can't find some of the answers to the puzzles. But then again, some of them I'm getting through pretty quickly, so that's not a problem. We will pick this up tomorrow. Hopefully I won't be as tired and out of it at the beginning of the stream, because hopefully we won't have that much excitement at nights anymore. Oy. Until then, Internet, take care and enjoy the games you play.